I wanted to talk about just as I was about to get out of jail. One of the guys, man, I was talking to, I had a beef with him when I first got in there. He was like, "You're going down," a couple times. Like, he didn't mean like you're gonna fight me or something. It was fucking weird. And the guys in jail, like the thing in the range was fucking, "They're all gonna laugh at you. They're all gonna laugh at you." Like, so I think this started when I was in there. The snowplows would come and just wham their fucking buckets right in front of our windows, man, like over and over when it snowed, like fucking flashing light vehicles going by the range all the time. Just the weirdest shit was happening in there. Not typical jail stuff. And then just as I was leaving, the night before I got out, the fucking, the guy who does the pills, man, Kurt, fucking, he was just like walking past down the hallway in front of the cells. Like, I waved to him. I was just sitting on my bed, like, he just, as he kept walking, like, I thought he was joking, like, but now that I've been out here and experienced this, no, he wasn't fucking joking. Sounds like he was fucking with another guy I spoke to. They're in control of the meds. They wouldn't give this one guy his fucking methadone, man. He was going crazy, like, you don't cut a guy off his fucking methadone, like, especially when he's in jail. What he's in for a robbery he didn't even do. Sounds like they're after him too. Anyway, so it started in jail. Then I went to the jail rally after, man. Some of the girls there just seemed like, "Really, what are you doing here?" Like, "You're protesting." The problem. Yeah, I guess that's the end of that story. I think there was more, but I'll just make a part 8. So that's Nazi psychoanalysis part 7. 7.